Good day, Microsoft Flight Simmers. Today we're going to do a flight with the Airbus A320neo in Microsoft Flight Sim. And let's go to a little Mad Map where we'll create a flight plan. So we're going to fly from Syracuse to Buffalo over here. Kilo Bravo Uniform Foxtrot. Now let's take a look at the weather, because I'm going to use real-time, real weather. And that's one of the things I like about Microsoft Flight Sim. It does do a pretty good reproduction of the actual weather. So right now, that's what it looks like. It looks like there's some snow just north of Syracuse, and in Niagara Falls, Buffalo area, there's snow coming down. So it'll be cold. An interesting flight, and we might not have very good visibility there when we approach. So we're going to be doing an ILS landing and approach using the autopilot, and we're also going to do a cold start from the gate, and we will go through a checklist. So it's going to take a while to do it, but it's very realistic, and we'll discuss that once we get into it. So I'm going to go back here to a little map and create the flight plan first. So there's Syracuse right there. So I'm going to hold my mouse right over that icon for the airport, and we can see the preferred runways, because of the wind, is 15 and 28. You can see the elevation is 409 feet. So under NOAA station in the tower, that's where you get your winds. So out of 21013 knots. So that's why they're preferring those runways. So I got to pick a runway, and it's going to be 28. Now I've got these feathers turned on, and you do that up here by clicking up on that icon. Anything that's blue has been activated. And you can see that this runway is an ILS runway, so it's not going to matter for departure, but I'm going to select a gate here. So I'm going to pick that as our departure, and then I'm going to pick a gate, and it's runway 28 we should get. So because we get the Airbus, I'm going to pick one of these larger aircraft here. So I'm going to pick gate, see if I can get gate 56 as our departure. So a cold start from there. Alright. So now I'm going to pick runway 28 for departure. And here it is here. And say okay. Now I'm going to fly at 8,000, see if that works okay. And also up here under tools, you're going to want to make sure you're connected to Microsoft Flight Sim. So you're going to select this one and say connect. Now you can check these boxes as well. So this is a free software, little map, so you can just Google it, download it. There's a little manual that tells you exactly how to use. Very easy to use, and you can just watch me create a flight plan very simply here. So I've got the start of the flight plan. Now we need to go to our destination. Zoom in on Buffalo here. Buffalo Niagara International, right click on that, select that as your destination. So we got a direct GPS route right now. So now I'm going to select a runway. So I'll hold my mouse button over there and take a look at the NOAA station Medar, and it says it prefers runway 23 because of the wind, which is coming out of 220 at 19 knots, gusting to 32, so it's fairly windy there right now, so it might make a tricky landing for me. Runway 23 is an ILS runway, which is great. So I'm going to select runway 23, and you can do that by clicking on here if you want, and you can select your destination runway that way, as well as using this little button up here. So I'm going to say 23, you can see it's ILS, and say OK. Next thing next thing I want to do is see if there are arrival procedures, which I'm sure there are. So right click on there, show arrival procedures, and now we want to look for a runway 23 with an I in front of it. See right there, this is RIL. So if you click on the I, that's an ILS runway, and there's the waypoint for your approach. And you can see, I'll just back off here, you can see that would be the approach, that blue, and this would be your go around or missed approach. So I'm just going to right click on that and say insert. Okay, so we've got our flight plan, you know, a basic flight plan, but you can also ask a little nav map to calculate some waypoints for you. So you hit adjust, see if it doesn't like that altitude, it could change it to 10,000 or 6,000. Or if you had 7,000, for example, which would be flying in the opposite direction, let's say I have 7,000 in there. So that would be from west to east. So if you're going east to west, it's an even number, and if you're going west to east, it's an odd altitude. So hit adjust there, you see it just adjusted it. So, you know, if I had 7,500, it would do the same thing. But anyway, I'm gonna calculate, see if it'll calculate. And it did. So if it doesn't, you'll get a little warning here saying, you know, there's something wrong, either your airspace is not acceptable or your altitude, because it could be terrain in the way. But let's take a look at our elevation map here. You can see the terrain is fairly flat here. So that green stuff at the bottom, and there's our top of climb, top of descent, and there's our waypoints. So the next thing you want to do is hit save button up here, and it will save it to a folder that it created itself when you installed the nav map. You just hit save. And then if I go to file, I can click export this flight plan as a Microsoft Flight Simulator Plan 2020. And you have to pick your folder, and I created this folder right here. So I'm going to hit save. So we're good. I can close this off, downsize that window, and you can also make this a little bit smaller and tuck it up in the corner if you want to refer to it while you're flying from time to time. So if I go back here, click on the Microsoft Flight window, it closes down little nav map. So I'm just going to go to the world map, and you see how this popped up. Now sometimes this space more will not show up. If it doesn't, just go back and go back in again and get this, because you're going to need that to load and save the flight plan. So we're going to load from this PC, and now we're going to go to My Passport. It's an external drive, and we're going to go to Microsoft Flight Plan, and we're going to look for that one to Buffalo. So there it is right there. Click on that, lights up down here, then you can say open. So what's happened is the flight plan that you created in little nav map has been now imported into the aircraft in Microsoft Flight Sim, and you can see that Microsoft Flight Sim has shown you your flight plan and your waypoints. You can look at your nav log, and you can see we're going to 8,000 feet, and departure, arrival, and here's some frequencies right here, and we've got our elevations here. So when we get to this point, we're going to be needing to go to 2,300 feet altitude, and it's kind of giving you your speeds here. But we'll discuss that one during the flight. So I'm just going to click on here. I'm just going to click ready to fly. So now if you So here we are ready to fly. I'm going to be using the Thrustmaster throttle, and Thrustmaster joystick, keyboard, and a mouse to do the flight. So here's our aircraft sitting at the gate. Looks like it's snowing right now as well. So all you need to do is hit ready to fly. All right, so we got a cold start here. And we're going to go through the checklist. Now, I just want to mention something about the Microsoft provided checklist, which normally works very well for starting your aircraft, especially if you don't know where everything is located. However, I've noticed there is an issue right here. When you try and hit APU on, APU start, it will spool up and then shut down to 0%. So some of you may have been experiencing some issues with this aircraft using the checklist where it will begin to start and then shut down. So I'm not going to use this checklist. Instead, I'm going to go through a checklist which I'll provide to you. So the first thing we want to do, we're sitting at the gate, so I want to turn on external power. It says it's available, so click that on.
Clearance delivery Nasair 616 IFR to Buffalo, ready to copy.
So I've got ATC turned on.
Nasair 616 is cleared to Buffalo Airport as filed. Take off runway 15 climb and maintain 8,000 feet.
We're taking off runway 15.
Departure frequency is 134.275 squawk 4224.
Nasair 616 cleared to Buffalo Airport as filed. Take off runway 15 climb and maintain 8,000 feet. Departure on 134.275 squawk 4224.
Nasair 616 read back, correct. Contact ground on 121.7. Good day.
So I've got the co-pilot under my assistant settings taking care of changing the comm frequencies and speaking to ATC. So it lightens the load on the pilot. So let's just take a look at what we need to do. The first thing, like I said, was turn on the external power. Then the next thing, you want to press Control 7 and make sure that that parking brake is on while you're sitting at the gate. So this is part of your checklist startup. And then I press Control 7, we go back to where we were. Just going to go outside, and next thing I'm going to do is just like if there were chocks or blocks here, that you want to check and make sure that they are removed and then that the engines are clear. So this would be a basic walk around that the captain and co-pilot would do the aircraft perhaps. Let's go back inside. So I want to make sure that the throttle is on idle, and I'm just going to press escape here for a second and go to controls and show you what I'm using here. So we got the mouse, we got a keyboard, so I will use some of the keyboard functions like B for barometric pressure, just B Bravo, and G Golf for landing gear up and down. And then I've got the joystick, and all these buttons are programmed for various things. These would bring the flaps up and down. This is for braking. This will center your view. So, you know, parking brake, spoilers, trim up and down, etc. So you can program those however you want. Now, I do find that the TWCS throttle works quite well. I've got a lot of these buttons programmed here, like this one. If I pull back on 10, it'll give me reverse thrust. So ATC, etc. So you can program these buttons however you want, but I do find the throttle works very well for trying to control your approach speed. All right, so let's go back. Now that you know what I'm using to fly this thing, and we'll go to resume. All right, so Let's take a look at that throttle then. Okay, so you want to make sure that that is in idle position. Your engine masters, that's these two buttons right here, they have to be off. And your batteries, we're going to turn them on now. So I'm just going to go overhead here, find the batteries, battery one, battery two. So I'm going to put them on. And you can see that they're on. And then generator switches. Generator switches should be on. So that's on, and that's on. But you can see it's reading false right now because everything isn't started up. Alright, so the next thing we want to do is ADIRS up here. Now this is, you know, inoperative, unfortunately, but they have to be set on nav, and that's been done for you by Microsoft Flight Sim. Now the panel lights on if they're required. So right down here we have panel lights, so you can turn them on, so not too dim in here. And then panel displays, I believe that's down below here. Yeah, that's these little dials here. So you can turn them up. Now they don't seem to be making any difference. So I don't know, sure, even though you can turn them, I'm not sure they make these screens any brighter. Alrighty, so nav lights on. So I'm just going to go back up again and find the nav light here, right there. So we turn that on. And the beacon lights, we're going to turn the beacon lights on. You just got to get them to highlight in blue and then you can click on them. Emergency lights, they're inoperative, but you would have those emergency lights armed. Seatbelt, let's just fasten the seatbelts for anyone that's on board here. No smoking. Anti-ice, we're going to put the anti-ice on because of the snow and the colder weather. And then we're going to put this probe heat on as well. So landing gear lever, we want to make sure that that's down. There's the landing gear lever there. I just press Control 3 to get that. All right, so flaps need to be up and the spoilers need to be retracted just for this stage of the checklist. So Control 6 probably give me the flaps, Control 7 maybe. There we go. So they're up, and then this is your spoiler, and it's retracted. So I have a button here on my Thrustmaster throttle that I can click, which will arm that. So that's armed. You get a little white bar at the bottom there, and then that's retracted. Fuel quantity, let's just go and check the fuel quantity here. You can see we have fuel on board, where it's located in the wings, the kilogram weight. Right now, fuel used is zero. The engines haven't started yet. So there's some information there. The other thing you can check, this is operational, and so is this button. So that switches you to the engine so you can monitor the engines. The other buttons, unfortunately, aren't operative on that panel. So once we've done that, we want to do, you can check the weather with ATIS. I'm not going to do that, flight services, but that's something you could do with ATC. But once you get them on, they kind of are a little distracting. So right now I'm going to go Control 7 and go to the transponder here. So right now, transponder should be set to standby, and it is set, and that should be okay for now. We're going to turn this on after in the checklist. I'm going to go up and check the multi-purpose control display unit. I believe that is Control 4, Control 5. Control 5 on your keyboard. So what I want to check here is make sure the flight plan's been entered, which it has. You can scroll through that. And the other thing I want to check is the RNAV, radio nav. Make sure that the ILS runway 23 frequency has been entered. And it has. Now, if you want to check and make sure that's correct, it's 111.30. You can go to the little nav map. And I'm just going to close that window now for now. Bring this up. We're going to go over here and take a look. And you can see that the frequency for that runway is 111.30 megahertz. And the glide slope is 3 degrees that we're going to try and pick up when we get there. So I'll just close that down again. So these other things, like this has all been entered for you. You don't have to worry about it. Now, some of these, if you're really knowledgeable and want to get really into it, you can start making changes here like they would in the real world. But this is just for Microsoft Flight Sim, and basically they've set this up more or less for a successful flight if you do things properly. Now here's our V1 VR and V2, and let's just check and see. I want to take a look at those speeds. Yeah, see, depending on the weather, these can change. The wind you're flying into, etc. So it's not always the same. So anyway, you want to make sure you're aware of that. Hey, I'll go through a few of these other things and you can see the data that's been entered. So you can get into fuel preferred and your secondary flight plan, ATC, COM, etc. So I'm going to go back to flight plan and leave it there. So at this point, the pilot and co-pilot would probably do a departure briefing and then check to make sure all the doors are closed. Now, right here, that button you would press and they'd be able to see what the doors are like. Consider that done. Now for our startup, this is where you can run into problems with this aircraft using the checklist. So for startup, we're going to go up above and we're going to put on these fuel pumps. And I find if you don't put these fuel pumps on, when you go to the APU master switch and start, if they're not on, this spools up and shuts down. So I'm going to click on the APU master switch. And then I'm going to click on APU start. And you see it stayed on. I believe if these weren't on the pumps, this would turn off. That's what's been happening when I try and use the checklist. So, APU generators, APU bleed, we want to do that. So, APU bleed, turn that on, and the APU generator. Make sure that's on. So you can hear the engines starting up a bit. Okay, so at this point, you request a pushback. So when you do a pushback, your external power is going to go off because you're no longer at the gate where you're getting external power. Because I did not ask ground services for a power truck, but that's probably why that split up. So let's see if we can do a pushback. So in order to do a pushback, you're going to have your throttle on idle. I'm going to go outside so you can see. Make sure the engines are clear and everything. And you can ask ATC. You need to make sure your parking brake is off. side, and I'm going to try ATC, see if I can get ground service to give me a pushback.
Syracuse ground, Nasair 616 requesting pushback.
Nasair 616 pushback request accepted.
Okay. So you can request a pushback to the right or left.
Syracuse ground, Nasair 616 requesting pushback tug to steer the aircraft to the left.
So here's the power truck. Here's the baggage. Let's just load our baggage. I'm just going to go inside and go up above here. That external power may go off once we get pushed back away from the gate. I'm just going to keep an eye on this.
Syracuse ground, Nasair 616 requesting pushback tug to push the aircraft straight.
Yeah, I just don't want to bump into this other aircraft here. So once I get stopped here, I'll put that parking brake back on. Now I have a program button for that, so I won't actually show you.
Syracuse ground, Nasair 616 requesting the end of pushback.
Okay, so I didn't request that myself. The co-pilot just automatically did it. So now I'm going to put the parking brake on. Let's go back inside. And you can see our external power switch is off now. Okay, so let's continue with our parking brake off. And then parking brake on. And then we're going to continue with our startup. So thrust levers need to be on idle. So make sure they're on idle. Engine area clear outside? Yes. Mode selector, ignition start. To start right here, and then the left engine is engine one. We're going to turn that on. And we're going to watch our N1 and N2 fuel flow. So let's just go control three. There's N2, N1.
Syracuse ground, Nasair 616 with Oscar ready to taxi IFR.
Nasair 616 taxi to and halt short of runway 15 using taxiway Echo Delta. Contact tower on 120.3 when ready.
Taxi to and hold short runway 15 using taxiway Echo Delta, Nasair 616.
Want to check your oil pressure and make sure it's looking okay? PSI, just give it time to spool up. There's the temperature coming up. So you can see it's right, this right engine's minus 4. You can hear a noise right now, so it sounds like a dog barking. That's the engine just starting up. So let's go up above and make sure the generator switch is on. Yeah, see, now this one still says fault, but this one's now okay. So we're going to repeat that for the other engine now. So it's just a matter of turning that one on, and the same thing should happen. Engine starting up okay. Remember, I've got the parking brake on right now and the throttle on idle. So you want to check the oil pressure generator switch up above again and the fuel flow. So I'm just going to up above. Okay, so that generator's on, the fault thing's gone off. Now this hydraulic pump switches, they would normally be turned on, but they're not operative, so it's on, that's done for you. So APU we can turn off and turn the mode selector back to. I'm just going to let the engine really spool up first before I turn it off. So let's look here. So everything looks good. So I should be able to turn this off now. Okay. And we should be able to turn that mode selector back to normal. Just got to scroll with your mouse. All right, so that's our startup checklist. Now, before we taxi, we're going to make sure that the external power is disconnected and turned off, which we already checked, and that we want to make sure that we have our probe window heat on. And then our altimeter. I'm going to press Control 2 here. And we want to make sure that this altimeter is set. So E Bravo on your keyboard, just changed it. So the altimeter is set. And your heading indicator, if you need to set that, but we're going to be using the autopilot. Flight director needs to be on. Flight director works with the autopilot to actually follow your flight plan. Now when we take off, the auto throttle will automatically go on. So this is, you can select ARC or NAV, that'll change this navigation display screen. And this is for zooming in and zooming out on that screen. That. Speed we're not going to worry about because the auto throttle is going to come on when the autopilot goes on. This is your approach button. This is your expedite button, which we won't be using. This is the localizer we can turn on when we get close to our approach runway to pick up the ILS frequency. So you can see the co-pilot has some similar instruments on that side, dials, etc. And let's see what else. This is our primary flight display. You can see on it we have our speed gauge or ribbon. And on this side we have our altitude gauge. You can see it's set to 5,000 right now. We're going to set that to, I believe, 8,000. Yes, but we'll listen to ATC.
Caution the Airbus A20N on the taxiway.
So basically I'm just checking these instruments here to make sure everything is okay. The standby instruments are working fine. And I did a overview of this cockpit if you want to know what these are all called on one of my videos called Airbus Cockpit Overview. Alright, so let's see. We're going to set the autopilot when we take off. You want to make sure your radios and avionics are set properly. And we have checked the radio nav frequency down here. We've already checked that. And our avionics are working fine, you can see. Everything looks good. Now, for flight controls, we can check the flight controls. Give you an idea what that looks like. Just going to try and back off here. So, there's a console for the captain. You just want to make sure that's working okay with your joystick. And the same thing with the co-pilots over there. Right over here. Make sure that's working okay. Okay, so that's part of the checklist. Looks like we got a plane in front of us here, but anyway, we'll resolve that one. once we get rolling here.
Auto brake.
I want to make sure the auto brake is on. So, control 3. You can see there's quite a bit of stuff to do here. So you set that to max. And when you're on landing, this is, this one seems to work with this one, but you can't put it on max for landing. Flight controls, 3 and correct, we've done that. And you can request clearance to taxi. We've already got the clearance to taxi. So I'm going to... taxi out to the runway. We're going to need our taxi lights on. So let's make sure the taxi lights are on. All right. I think we're set to go here. I'm going to go outside so I can see where we are here. Get into a position here. See where we're going here. So I'm going to release the parking brake and we're going to start rolling, hopefully. So you don't want to taxi at more than 20 knots of runway. These planes are sticking out a bit here. Just barely missing that. You don't seem to develop a object struck if you go through a plane. They just seem to dissolve magically in Microsoft Flight Sim. So wouldn't have stopped our flight. But if you hit a building, like the terminal or something, then your flight's over, or a tree or something. So I'm just going to taxi down here and then do the before takeoff checklist. So I've got these blue chevrons turned on in my assistant settings, and that'll basically help you get to your runway or your gate. A little nav map's really helpful for that too. So when we land, we might need to use a little nav map to find a gate, because I'm finding with the Airbus, they're not assigning a gate and allowing you to bring over the jetway, etc. For some reason, I'm not sure. I don't know if it's the destination airport you're going to or what. But we'll try it today and see. But anyways, everything looks pretty realistic here. You can see there's some snow on the ground. So if you don't turn on your de-icing, your instruments could freeze up because the pitots on the outside of the aircraft, they can ice up and the airflow through them gets blocked and you can't send the correct data to the flight director in order to help the autopilot do its job. And therefore your primary flight display, which you see right here, these two dials may seize up on you and not read accurately. So then you'd have to use standby instruments or the co-pilots or whatever if one of them fails, just to see what the issue is. So I'm just going to go outside again. And just cut back on the throttle there. So we're at our runway 15 here. We're going to need our clearance to take off here, which we should get once you get to this point.
Syracuse Tower Nassair 616 at runway 15 ready for departure IFR to Buffalo.
Nassair 616 altimeter 290.72 wind 212 at 14. Cleared for takeoff runway 15.
So there's the barometric pressure, 2 miles.
Clear for takeoff runway 15, Nasair 616.
Here's our wind. So it's at 14 out of 212. So I'm gonna pull up here now. We've got our clearance, and I'm gonna stop, put on the parking brake, and go through our before takeoff checklist. Make sure we have a successful departure here. Okay, I'm just gonna pull up and stop right here. I'm gonna put on the parking brake. All right, so let's check the barometric pressure. They gave it to us, I think. You can see it up here. And it looks like it's okay. I'm gonna press B anyway on the keyboard, and it didn't change, so we know it's set correctly. All right, so flaps, we're gonna have to set the flaps to 1. So, I'm just gonna bring those flaps down here. Inside, you can see those flaps coming down here. Our spoilers should be armed. So here's our spoilers. So I'm going to arm those. I have a button program to do it, but you can just pull up on that with your mouse button. It's now armed. You can see that point there. Bar at the bottom, helping you out. The altitude, once again, make sure we got that set properly. 8,000, okay, 8,000, looking good there.
Exit 104, exit runway.
The auto brake should be on. We're going to double check it. So it's off right now. Let's just go back to it. Okay, so I had that on, but it went off. But we'll put it on again.
Exit 104, contact ground on 101.7.
Make sure that this is looking fine. Set to climb, nav, flight director, 1 and 2 are on, and our navigation display screen looks okay. So I'm just checking that. Flight control unit, everything looks fine down here and up here. Things look okay. Engines look fine. Just checking those as well. So we did check for our V1, VR, and V2. And that's, we're just going to double check that again. You can see, and like I said, that can change depending on the runway, the wind, the weather of the day. So in the checklist, I'm going to give you V1, VR, and V2 settings. But just remember to check that they are set. And I think you can trust these ones, and those are the ones you'd use for the particular day and the particular flight. Once again, we're going to go up above here, and we're going to turn on some lights. So taxi lights should be to take off, and then I'm going to turn on our landing lights, our strobe lights, our PTOT heat. Got it, our de-ice, we're going to check again. Okay, so let's turn on the landing lights.
Syracuse Tower, American 27305 miles, southeast inbound ILS.
Wainwright if we want because of the weather.
American 2730 Syracuse Tower. Altimeter 29.72 wind 212 at 14. Cleared ILS runway 28 approach.
So we want to make sure these are on.
Cleared ILS runway 28
this
approach
is on.
American
double
2730.
Checking. And the transponder now. Let's go down and put the transponder on. I'm going to turn the altitude RPTG on as well.
American 2730 wind 212.
Let me see if I click on it. Yeah. Seems like you click on that. If I try and scroll it with the mouse, it's scrolling the same route.
Cleared to land runway 28 American 2730.
So that completes that for pre-takeoff. Now for takeoff, I'm going to release the brakes, smoothly increase the thrust to about 40% M1 to spool up. Then I'm going to take off thrust full or to toga. And at 141 knots, which we saw on our instrument display down below, 141 is going to be committed. And then our rotate is going to be 151. And our V2 is going to be 155. So we're going to pitch up slowly. Then we're going to bring up our landing gear after we get a positive rate of climb. Our flaps up, passing our F-speed, and then our spoilers disarmed, our auto brake off, and our landing lights as required. Okay, so let's take off the parking brake. We're gonna roll. So we got a good rate of climb. I'm going to bring up the landing gear, G on your keyboard, and then I'm going to bring up my flaps. Okay, now I'm going to go inside the aircraft and put the autopilot on. So it's on. We should be climbing now. So what I'm going to do, I can put it into this auto throttle zone here for flying. So if you went above 10,000 feet, you'd probably turn off your landing lights. You're going to contact ATC as required. I'm going to recheck my barometric pressure. Didn't change. Taxi lights can go off. That's still on taxi, I believe. There we go. Fasten seat belts. You can let people take their seat belts off if you want now. All right, let's just see where we're at here. That we've reached our altitude. Just let the auto throttle control our airspeed. We should be flying at 250 in the cruise. So for cruise, you want your taxi lights off, your auto throttle in that position. Engine instruments, you want to monitor them, make sure everything looks okay here. Fuel quantity, you want to check your fuel, and we can do that by control 3. And just hit the fuel button here. See, your fuel looks okay. It's flowing nicely. The amount you're using for each engine, temperatures, etc. Alright, so I'm going to go back to engines again. Make sure that everything looks good there. So you want to make sure your radios are set properly, which they seem to be. Your active calm setting, and we're able to hear ATC. Now, sometimes I find with Microsoft Flight Sim, you lose ATC's voice, and you can only hear yourself talking to them. So that's why I have this little button that I can bring them up and make sure that I can see what they're saying. So these are set. So you want to check that. Your autopilot, you want to make sure it's working fine. Lights as required. If you want to get weather information, you can ask ATC. Altimeter, I think we've already checked that, but it doesn't hurt periodically through the flight to check that. So I'm just going to hit B on the keyboard again, and it just changed. Okay, so you want to constantly be checking that. You can see this come on right here. Okay, that's on. This will light up green, but right now the sun's shining. And we're going to put this on when we get close, these two, when we get close to our approach. So you keep an eye on your fuel quantities. If you travel forward in time, which you can do right here, you have to, I recommend anyway, putting everything in pause, checking your fuel quantities, because if it's a long flight, you can run out of fuel. You can top your fuel up just by fuel, just by hitting that button and just say reset your fuel if you run out of fuel for some reason on that.
133.25, Nass Air 616. Goodbye.
Okay, we changed the
center, Nass Air 616, 8,000 feet.
Nass Air 616, Boston Center altimeter, 29.71 radar contact. Continue to condo.
So that's okay, and we can continue to our waypoint. All right, so let's take a look at landing gear. It's always good to check to make sure that's up. And your flaps to make sure they're up. This we're going to have to earn on approach. So let's go outside and have a look at the weather, see what it looks like. Yeah, cloudy, looks like some snow below us. So, beautiful aircraft. Design with these winglets here. Okay, so let's have a look at a little map and see where we are. So, there's a trail I have turned on. You can turn that on by clicking this button. You can actually see how you path you followed and pick up waypoints. See, right now we're following the little nav map, the flight plan pretty accurately. And in some
cases, decimal 475, Nass Air 616. Cleveland Center, Nass Air 616, 8,000 feet.
Going to check the barometric pressure again. Change 2970.
Sunwing 90827, contact New York Center on 133.35.
Just a second.
Good day.
Up here. This feather here. We need to be within this feather for our approach to runway 23. So that's the ILS horizontal path we have to pick up. And then for the glide slope, this is, I'm just going to zoom, drag this over here. So this is the vertical feather, and we have to pick that altitude up in order to pick up the glide slope. The glide slope is 3 degrees, and there's the frequency. So we have to get within. So if we're up here too high, we're going to fly right over and miss it. We won't pick it up. If we're too low, same problem. So you want to be within that feather on your approach. So far, it's just a matter of monitoring our instruments. Now, for our approach, we're going to fasten seat belts, make sure our radios are set. We're going to try and get our speed to 210 knots. Our landing lights, we need to have them on, taxi lights on. We're going to arm the ground spoilers and the auto brake. We're going to set it. We're going to turn on LS or make sure it's on. Our flaps are going to go to 1. Our speed, we have to manage that. So I'm going to, as we get closer, turn off the auto throttle and just manage the speed with my Thrustmaster throttle. So I want to be looking at about 145 on approach, 145 knots or so. So you just got to manage it. Then we got to put our landing gear down, and our flaps will go to 2. And then full flaps as we get really close. On the final glide slope descent, try and establish about 145 knots and verify that your parking brake is off. You don't land with your parking brake accidentally on.
Settling
and your de-ice is on.
You are 65 miles northeast. Descend and maintain 14,000 feet. Expect ILS runway 23 approach via Golf Echo Echo transition. Cleared to Golf Echo Echo.
So it's just a matter of waiting right now, and we are in some poor visibility here. Let's go outside and have a look. Yeah, so the bottom line is we're in the clouds. Can't see too much. Just want to see if there's any icing up on the wings, windows. You can see some of these top tubes out here that are gathering information for the data. No one goes freezing up. So we can see the ground a bit, so it's not too bad. This airport here at first I thought was comfortable, but this is yeah, that's Greater Rochester International. Pretty good size airport. So we're following our way. There, you can see this is lit up in white, and that is the, our destination waypoint there at this current time.
Descend and maintain 4,000 feet. Expect ILS runway 23 approach by Golf Echo Echo transition. Clear to Golf Echo Echo, runway 9082.
So we are headed now to this one. It just switched over from Agen to Lorth, and then we're going to that. VOR station at Rochester, and then we'll travel on to these waypoints and this runway for approach. So you can scroll here.
Cleveland Center Allegiant Niner 201 is at 14,200 feet, climbing flight level 180.
We have all of this information for the day.
Allegiant
see
Niner
8,000 feet here, 4,600, then 2,300. Probably going to ask us to descend to 4,600 feet, I would imagine. So we'll just listen for that. So it could be a tricky landing if the visibility's bad. And this plane is a little tricky to land. I'm going to turn the autopilot off just before I land and just do it manually, because sometimes
Allegiant Niner 201 climb and maintain flight level 240.
Just let her finish. There is a margin of error involved in the ILS feather. In other words, it might bring you a little bit left or right of
climb
the center line of the runway. Sometimes it brings you right dead on the center of the runway. But if you have your autopilot turned off right at the last there, you can make any minor corrections and try and make a smooth landing. I'm going to put on the reverse thrust as well and hopefully slow the aircraft down. Some snow around Buffalo there. So let's just show you what the weather's going to look like as it progresses.
So,
this is what it's like right now. Bring it back. So we're flying into this. We just went through Rochester. Now we're flying into the snow. Right now we're just above the ceiling for the clouds. Getting a pretty clear view here, which is kind of nice. NEO on the Airbus A320 stands for New Engine Option. This is when they introduced the two new engine types for this aircraft. So they named it the NEO. A320neo is 1.8 tons heavier than the CEO, which was the previous engine options. But the takeoff and landing performance is the same with the modified rotation arm, adjusted with wingtip flap and wing slack angles and rudder deflection increased by 5% to cope with the higher thrust. The A320neo is half as loud as the A320 at takeoff, with an 85 decibel noise footprint. It gets better fuel efficiency too. So the A320 has two versions, the CEO version, which is current engine option, and the NEO version, which is the new engine option. The NEO version is an upgrade. improve fuel efficiency and reduce greenhouse gas emissions for the airlines. Take a look at Endeavor
5100 traffic is 10 o'clock,
see
4 miles at 7,400 feet Airbus A20N. Report them in sight.
Let's see if that's our next waypoint.
Nessair 616 traffic is 9 o'clock, 3 miles at 10,000 feet generic. Report them in sight.
Nessair 616 traffic in sight.
Climb and maintain flight level 310, Endeavor 5038.
So that is our next waypoint. Sometimes this stuff isn't imported exactly as the map has it, so I always like to check.
Endeavor 5100, have the traffic.
But all in all, it looks pretty good. I don't see this waypoint here being incorporated into the flight plan. So that one we probably won't go to. Let's take a look at that. Is that over here, right? Okay. So, let's have a look at what we got here again. Okay, so, what's probably going to happen here is sometimes ASAVO and Metroflex create their own approach to the runway. So that might be why they're not using this waypoint. They might be flying to this one and then swinging around like this. I'm not sure. We'll see. I've got this little tracker line on, so we'll be able to tell anyway. We should be getting information to descend shortly. We need to go to 4,600 for that waypoint.
Endeavor 5100, contact Cleveland Center on 127.475. Good day. Delta 1331, descend and maintain flight level 33. Going to 127.475, Endeavor 5100. Sunwing 9082, descend and maintain.
I'm going to check the barometric pressure again.
Descend and maintain.
So it just changed. Sometimes if you don't have that set right, you'll get air traffic control telling you to that you're above or below your assigned altitude. And that might be just because this isn't set properly. But we're not hearing anything from it, so we're doing okay.
Cleveland Center Brickyard 4552 is passing flight level 225, climbing flight level 290. Brickyard 4552 Cleveland Center radar. Contact continue to Lima Victor Zulu.
So basically I'm monitoring primary flight display.
Southwest 2560 climb and maintain flight level 370.
Our ND screen, navigational display screen.
Endeavor 4831, descend and maintain flight level 280.
This screen is known as the upper ECAM screen, engine and warning display. And this is the lower ECAM system display.
Expect ILS runway 23 approach by Golf Echo Echo transition. Clear to Golf Echo Echo.
That's our switching panel right here. This is your MCDU for the captain. MCDU for the co-pilot.
Southwest 2560.
That's our ECAM control panel. So if you're wondering what some of these things are, this is an integrated standby instrument system here. Okay, you can hear the auto throttle just adjusted our speed there. We're going to take this down to 210, I believe.
Expect ILS runway 23 approach via Golf Echo Echo transition. Clear to Golf Echo Echo. Endeavor 4831, descend and maintain flight level 280.
So the auto throttle is just adjusting our speed nicely right now, 210, which is what it should be. This is our alarms and warnings panel for the captain, and there's this little pilot over here. So if these come on, you know there's some issue that you're going to have to address. Engine failure, landing gear, something.
Endeavor 4817, climb and maintain flight level 210.
This is our EFIS control unit for
climb
the captain.
Climb and maintain 17,000 feet, JetBlue 2101.
That's the flight control unit, this area.
Endeavor 5038, so
flight control
contact
unit,
Cleveland Center.
And over here we have
EFIS
control unit for the first officer. That's the console for the captain, and over here we have the console for the pilot. Sort of like a joystick equivalent.
Endeavor 4817, climb and maintain.
Like I said, some of this stuff is inoperative. I'll take it down below for a second while we get some time.
Climb.
That's your speed brake.
It's
your flaps. This is your rudder trim, which is taken care of for you. It should be in this position, unless you want to start doing some manual setting yourself and fly the aircraft. Parking brake, of course, is off. This is a gravity gear extension.
Endeavor 4817, climb and maintain flight level 180.
If there's some failure in the system and the landing gear won't go down, this is a backup.
Lindbergh 4463, you
that's
are 42 miles southeast.
That's the cockpit door panel, which isn't really
climb
operative.
And maintain 13,000
feet. I think we got a printer
expect
over
ILS
here
runway 23 approach
that the
by a golf
flight crew can
NASA
use.
616 descend and maintain 4,000 feet.
Information.
Descend and maintain 4,000 feet, Nessair
okay.
616.
Going down to 4,000 feet now.
Endeavor 4831, descend and maintain flight level 280.
So I'm going to press Control 2 and put this to 4,000. If you click here, it goes in hundreds. Click again out here, it goes in thousands. But in order to get us to descend, it's this right here. If I use my right mouse button, it activates.
Nessair 616, contact Buffalo approach on 126.5. Good day. Sunwing 9082, contact Buffalo approach on 126.5.
And I have to keep an eye on the speed because I don't believe the auto throttle should actually bring us in at the right speed for approach.
Goodbye.
But I find that it
Buffalo
doesn't.
Approach Nessair 616 is at 7,700 feet, descending 4,000 feet.
You see this diamond?
Nessair 616 Buffalo approach altimeter 29er decimal.
That is the glide slope
continue.
Diamond. And the other one lines
Nessair
up this way.
Nessair 616, you are 21 miles northeast. Maintain present heading and altitude. Expect ILS runway 23 approach via Trava transition.
Now this is on.
Clear to Trava.
Yeah, ILS. Button. So if I turn it off, you
maintain
lose the stop.
Maintain present heading and altitude. Expect ILS
see,
runway 23 approach
so
via Trava transition clear to Trava Nessair 616.
You want that on. You want the flight director on.
Buffalo approach, Sunwing 90082, 6,000 feet. Sunwing 90082, Buffalo approach altimeter 29.67 radar contact. Continue to the KYI.
And you want the LS on. So that accidentally went off. You know, a little tricky getting it back on again. So you want this on, and you want the flight director on. Auto throttle, I'm going to have to take it off. Because we really need to be at about 180. So let's take a look at our approach. Fasten seat belts. Make sure your radius is set.
Contact Buffalo Tower on 120.5 when inbound.
Okay.
Tower on 120.5, Nasair 616. Buffalo Tower, Nasair 616.17 miles northeast inbound ILS runway 23 approach.
Right now.
Nasair 616 Buffalo Tower. Altimeter 29.67. Wind calm.
You can see that other diamond coming over. So let's take a look at.
Cleared ILS runway 23 approach, Nasair 616.
So here we are here. See what's happening? It's doing its own thing, which is good. So we're going to probably swing around and line up with this runway on an approach that they've designed themselves. Hopefully this goes okay.
Runway 908215 miles northeast inbound ILS runway 23 approach.
Yeah, it's turning again. So
Buffalo
let me
Tower.
Just go back to this checklist.
Landing
lights on.
Cleared ILS runway 23 approach.
Taxi lights on. Ground spoilers armed.
Cleared ILS runway 23
so
approach.
Arm
those.
We want to put on our.
Exigent 641.
Like I told you, this doesn't seem
taxiway.
To want to go on, so just put on. Auto brake there.
Generic 1 Quebec Sierra. Follow the generic on the runway.
LS is on. Flaps
two
down
one.
One.
Two
we're going
to
put them
clear
down shortly.
Runway, two
and then we're going to get our speed to 180. And then put our flaps down 2.
Clear to land runway, two three.
And
generic
landing gear
Quebec
down.
Sierra.
Flaps 3. Full flaps. Try and get it to 145. And we also have to put on the
Exigent 641 contact ground on 123.2. Buffalo Tower Southwest 2329 at runway 23 ready for departure.
Let's see where we're at here before
that map. Okay. Southwest 23.
So right now I'm
going to
put on localizer.
Traffic is generic on final.
I have to go control 2. Doesn't seem to work unless
going to
you
133.2
bring up that screen. And I'm going to take off the auto throttle and cut
Southwest
back. I want to get it to 180.
All the aircraft on final. Wind 231
now
at
I'm
going
to hit approach.
Clear to land runway 23.
This diamond here, when it gets down to here, we're going to start descending. So I need to cut back on the throttle.
Clear to land runway 23.
Well, I'll tell you. Can't see a darn thing, so it's going to be a tricky landing. So I'm going to put the flaps down. One. So they went down one, and I'm going to put the gear down. Show you the elevation. So there we are. We're right inside the feather. That's speed on 180 and cut it back to about 145. And we cut the speed back now. Put down some more flaps. More flaps. Try and keep my speed at 150. 5.
Wind 231 at 26. Clear to land runway 23.
Boy, it's snowy weather.
Here. Clear to land runway 23, NASAIR 616.
So we're descending. I'm going to check the barometric pressure again. Just press B on your keyboard. See if that changes. And the speed looks pretty good. I don't know how well I'm lined up. What's on the side? Yeah, look. So this says I'm lined right up with the runway. Speed up. You could not pull this off if you weren't using an ILS. This just wouldn't be
1,000.
I can't even see the lights in the runway. I think it said 500. I'm going to take the autopilot out. Spoiler should go on. We have to land. Okay, I'm going to shut the autopilot off.
60, 50,
40, 40, 40, 40, 40, 40,
40, 40,
40, 40, 40, 40, 40, 40, 40, 40, 40, 40,
40,
40, 40, 40, 40, 40, 40, 40, 40, 40, so, once we land, so for landing, we made sure our landing gear is down, autopilot is off, auto throttle is off, landing speed, we got it around 145. After touchdown, we did reverse thrust, spoilers were extended, we verified that, we braked as required, and at about 60 knots, we canceled the reverse thrust. After landing, the spoilers were disarmed and the flaps were hung up. Engine mode selector should be in norm. So let me just go bring you down to that. So let's just take but right here, that should be a norm. So the landing lights we can turn off.
Exit at 641. Follow the aircraft on final.
We can put them off.
Wind 231 at 26.
And we can turn
clear
off
to land
the taxi
runway 23. Clear to land runway 23, Lindbergh 4463.
Yeah, you can leave the anti-ice on if you want, but
clear
I'm going
to
turn it off
runway
right 23. Now. I don't
exit
think
at 641.
I'll just leave that on.
Going to 126.5, Endeavour 5337.
So, the transponder we can turn off. Let's just go down to Control 7, I believe. And we can click on that or rotate it off. Here, turn that off too. So, this is automatically set by Microsoft Flight Sim 4. You don't have to really set that unless you want to play around with these buttons and change it. Scenario. So the parking brake's on right now. So what I'm going to do is see if they'll give us a gate. Let me just see if they'll bring up a gate for us. So ground services, oh no, tune Buffalo. Let's just see what they say. So, let's go back. Back to clearance. Request taxi to gates. Okay.
Buffalo Ground Nassair 616 taxi to the gate.
Nassair 616 taxi to gate 11 using taxiway Bravo
okay.
Alpha.
Okay. Sometimes they won't give you a gate.
Taxi to gate 11 using taxiway Bravo Alpha Nassair 616.
Bravo Alpha. Okay, so let's take a look at little map. Okay, so let's look at gate 11, see where it's at. All right, there's gate 11 right there. So that's why I like little map. We can just watch our progress right down to this gate. And if they didn't assign you a gate, you can say, okay, these are open, I'll just go to them. So let me just zoom in on this a little bit again, close this, and I'm going to downsize this. So you can watch our progress here. All right, so I'm gonna have to release the parking brake. These things are gonna turn off
to the gate
there. Let's just taxi to the gate.
Lindbergh 4463,
and then we'll do parking
taxi
and shut
to gate
down.
7 using taxiway Alpha.
All right, so. I'm not going to go too close to those aircraft. We're sticking out a bit. So there might be somebody there to direct us right into the gate, hopefully. See this little screw here? When you're lined up with that screw, the nose is lined up pretty much with wherever you're aiming.
Buffalo Ground, United Tree 40, requesting the end of pushback. United Tree 40, request to end pushback received.
See if I can line this up perfect. Otherwise, the jetway will not come over if you're not lined up perfect. Remember, I said that little screw there.
Buffalo Ground, United Tree 40,
this blue line should
disappear.
Ready
to taxi IFR.
United
Tree
40,
taxi to and hold short runway 23 using taxiway Charlie Alpha cross runway 32 Alpha. contact tower on 120.5 when ready.
I'm just going to close down this window here.
Taxi 2 and hold short runway.
Let's see
two
if
three
I tap the space
way,
bar, now I can see it better.
Tree, 2 Alpha United 340.
Let's go outside, see what the heck's going on here, see where this guy is. Okay, I'm just going to bring it a little bit further forward. That green box should disappear. It was blue, turns green when we get in. There we go, we're good. The jetway's coming over. I'm going to put on the parking brake using my button. There we go. Alrighty, let's finish our shutdown. So, I'm going to go back inside the aircraft and finish our final checklist. Okay, we got a door open, so let me just go control. Press my button to go inside here. Okay, so that's a warning, so I'm just going to turn that off because it'll drive you crazy. Alright, so I'm going to turn off the taxi lights. And I'm going to turn off these other lights as well. Got to get them highlighted in blue. Strobe lights, beacon, wing lights.
Buffalo Ground, exit 641 taxi.
See, we got external power. So what I'm going to do is go to ground services and ask them for some stuff. Okay, let's go outside so you can see. I'm going to request power supply.
Buffalo Ground, Nassair 616, could you please send a ground power unit?
I'll let you see these guys working in Buffalo as we have a vision. There's the ground power. So we get some external power. We're going to request them to have the other
Buffalo baggage. Ground, Nassair 616, could you please send the baggage?
Nassair 616 baggage is on the way.
Since this is a continuing flight, we are going to request catering services.
Buffalo Ground, Nassair 616, could you please send the catering truck?
And in some cases, they actually will send a fuel truck, but it usually takes quite a while.
Buffalo Ground, Nassair 616, could you please send a fuel truck?
Nassair 616, a fuel truck is on the road.
So I really do enjoy this little part that they've included in the subplates, and it's kind of fun to make it as authentic as possible. You can see we have a ground power supply hooked up here. And there's our catering truck, there's our baggage guy, all kind of fun. This guy's still standing here because I probably could have pulled a little further ahead, but I'm just going to leave it at that. This is obviously far ahead. So, food going on, baggage going on for the next flight. It's too bad they don't have it going off first for a minute and on. But anyway, two trucks with baggage takeaway and baggage arrival. But at any rate, let's go inside the aircraft and continue shutting this thing down. So we made sure we had the parking brake set. I'll show you that once more. There you go. That's on. And thrust levers are on idle. Right here, I got them on idle. We established contact with ground operations. Electrical power is established. Engine 1 and 2, we're going to shut them off now. This should be on norm. Parking brakes, once again, double check. Nav lights off. Exterior lights off. Interior floodlights off. Okay, let's go up here. So we have the door opened automatically. You don't do that yourself. It's sort of inoperative. So we'll turn off the flight director, LS, and make sure everything else is off. Autopilot's off. Turn that off on landing. So landing gears down, check. These should be all off. And speed brake. Let's go back to the spoilers and make sure, yeah. So they are turned off. I did that after landing. So let's go up above. And we are going to turn these fuel pumps off. External power, these are saying fault again. Panel lights off. That's what that was. So these should be turned to off, but they're inoperative. You know, they're just always on nav, so don't worry about those. APU should be off, and it is. Just checking. Our avionics will go off once I turn the batteries off. By using my shift and arrow keys and my alt arrow keys, I can actually get up here and look at this panel. And that is your circuit breaker panel, and pretty much everything is inoperative up here, I believe. And just take a look at the aircraft for a second, then I'm going to turn everything off inside. So, there we are. Everything's been disconnected. I didn't see any fuel truck come. But sometimes they will, if you wait long enough, show up. So let's go back inside the aircraft for a second. Okay, I'm going to go overhead. And the final thing I'm going to do is I'm going to turn off the batteries and the external power right here. Okay, so that should shut down the avionics as well. So the aircraft is, you know, for Microsoft Flight Sim anyway, shut down and parked until we're ready to bring some passengers on board. So I just want to say thank you very much for joining me on this flight. I hope you learned something about flying the Airbus A320neo, and if you liked it, give me a thumbs up and subscribe. Otherwise, I will catch you next time on one of my other videos about flying planes in Microsoft Flight Simulator. Thank you very much once again for joining me. Goodbye, have a great day, and warmer weather soon for Buffalo, I hope. So this is real time, real weather, and I think it was the 18th of February.